Hey, what's up YouTube? It's your girl Nadia, aka Nadaysha, and I'm back with another video. Basically, I'm just going to talk about my first photo shoot experience and just give you guys some tips if you are interested in starting to model and you just want to hear from someone who basically doesn't know what she's doing and is just putting herself out there. So yeah, I did a photo shoot this morning and I really enjoyed it. It was something different. At first I was really, I guess, shy and uncomfortable, and I was really tired, but after a while, you know, changing outfits and just going to different backdrops and different scenes, it was just really exciting and I really loved the outfits and everything about it. So moving on, first tip would be, I'd say, to get enough sleep. I haven't slept for the past 24 hours, really. I think I just had like a nap or something like that, but I haven't really slept, and so like you can see it in my eyes, like I was really tired and I just wasn't completely awake. So I would suggest either, you know, getting a good night's sleep. Tip number two would be bring as much clothes as possible. I think that was one of the mistakes I made. I brought two additional outfits, not including what I had on, and I felt like I didn't have enough variety to, you know, give the shoot something more. Find out what the dress code is, or what either the photographer, the designer, or whatever type of director, whoever's in charge, what their vision is, and from there decide, you know, what you want to wear and bring clothes that help that. Be versatile, I would say, as well as even things that you probably ordinarily would think wouldn't look good, I guarantee you might bring it and it'll turn into something really dope and really amazing. So practice before you go. Practice is important. I think you need to know your face, you know, what's your best side, what's your best angle, poses that fit your body type and your face shape structure, and just, you know, getting comfortable and flowy, I think, helps a lot. And you know, just keep in mind that you want to keep moving for your photographer. I also suggest, when it comes to posing, is don't make your poses choppy. Make it a very flowing movement. You don't want to be here and then here and then here, because it's just too much and it's too fast, and there's a lot more chances that your pictures are going to come out blurry because you're moving so much. But if you do little moves, then the photographer is just taking pictures and it's not all over the place. So definitely practice. Practice is very, very important, I think. Tip number four, if there's no makeup artist available, if you don't know how to do makeup, or your everyday makeup you don't think is sufficient enough for the photo shoot, I would suggest talking to someone who does know how to do their makeup, or is a makeup artist, or you know, just find something online that's simple for you to do. Like, there's many options. I would say definitely go for a neutral makeup look, especially if you're going to be changing into various outfits. It'll definitely help if your face is fairly neutral. And tip five is use props. One thing that I did was I saw that there were lollipops available, and I actually brought the lollipop into the scene and I used it for a lot of my pictures. I think using props are great. We also had some donuts, which we were eating and put in the picture as well, just making it really playful. So use props, use your surrounding, use your background, use what's available to you. So shout out to the photographer. You can follow him on Instagram at googleishuman. Also, the line that I was shooting for is divineclothing.co. Check them out, follow them on Instagram, check out their website, look at their stuff. It's so dope. I really love the looks that we came up with with their line, their hats ASAP before they sell out. And thank you so much for watching. Keep your heels high and hold your heads even higher. Peace, love, and Nadayshaness.